ठीक है, हम कर दिए, वी कैन कंटिन्यू।
नाउ यू नो वी ऑल आर पासिंग थ्रू अ वेरी क्राइसिस पीरियड एंड यू वी ऑल आर अवेयर अबाउट दिस सिचुएशन। सो बेसिकली वी आर ऑल इन home quarantine because whole country is in lockdown for the outbreaking of COVID-19. So under this situation, our academic activities, our research work is not going on properly because our academic departments are not open. We cannot use our library also, though the Vishwavarti library network has taken some initiatives for our users during this lockdown period. We have provided remote access facilities to our users so that we can access a good number of electronic resources from our home. And also, we started this lecture series from 2nd May for our research scholars and others. I hope this will be helpful for them. Now, I have been assigned here to discuss the topic literature review, which is very, very important for our research work. And also, I would like to touch the referencing system, which is equally important in our research work. Now, let me start with literature review first. I would like to share my ideas of literature review with you. Now, see, in this phrase literature review, there are two words. First is literature, then is review. So we have to some literature for the purpose of review. The very word literature review seems to and a lot of anxiety among the research scholar, basically who meet this phrase for the first time, because literature review is not an easy task. It is a very difficult, it is a critically assessment of the literature. It is a evaluation of the literature on a particular topic. So it is not a simply summarization or description of the literature on a particular topic. So necessarily, the literature review takes much more time, and even several months to complete. It is very important to our research work because literature review fits into our research work. On the other hand, literature review, it is possible if we have some appropriate literature. So to search the appropriate literature, we need some skills on information retrieval, so that we can find out, we can search the literature effectively by using manual or computerized system. Because the main purpose of the literature review is to survey the previous study on a particular topic. So for this reason, we should have a set of useful literature for the purpose of reviews. So now one question may arise in our mind that how many sources of information are available in our society, in our hand, and which are the most important sources of information for a research work? Virtually, we may gather the information from anywhere. That may be media, that may be blog, website, journal, books, magazines, periodicals, even personal experience, expert opinions also. In general, there are three types of sources of information that covers all the documents available in our society, in our the primary documents, secondary documents, and you know, tertiary documents. And primary documents are those that deals with the primary information, new things, new ideas of a known fact. Whereas the secondary sources are derived from the primary documents, and tertiary sources are those are based on the, that's a based on the primary and secondary sources. Here some examples are given. Now see, like periodicals, research technical reports, conference proceedings, patents, standard thesis and dissertations, research report, trade literature, laboratory notebooks, official publications, correspondence, personal files. These are the example of primary sources. And secondary sources are the bibliographies, indexing, abstracting services, you know, monographs, textbooks, dictionaries, encyclopedia, handbook. And on the other hand, tertiary sources are yearbook, directories, bibliography of bibliographies, guidebooks. So these are the three sources. All are important for a research work, but I think primary sources is very important because it deals with the new things, new ideas, new interpretation. So if we think for a research work, we have to consult the primary sources to find out the research topic, to find out the research gap. That's why I think primary sources is very important than other two sources. Now, see, research design, basically it is a blueprint of a research work. Research design refers to an overall strategy of research work. It integrates the different components of the research work in a logical way. How are these components of a research? We mentioned here, title of the study, research problem, literature review, procedure of the study, data analysis, interpretation of result, findings, chapterization, bibliography. These are the very important components of a research work. This is also known as the operational stage of a research work. Now see, if you follow a thesis, we will find these steps, these components in this thesis. And all these components in the thesis are interrelated. They are integrated in a logical way. So this is the research design that we have to follow to make a research work. So, and you see, literature review is one of the most important components of a research work. So, though it is difficult, but it is important for a research work. So, we cannot ignore it. We have to do this. Without, we cannot think about a research work. Now, What does mean by the literature review? It's a very simple that it's a comprehensive study of the literature that are available for a given questions. It is a summary, it is an evaluation, it is an analysis of the literature that are available on a particular topic. And it is also an explanation of what research have already been done on a particular topic. On the other, we can say that a literature review is an integral part of the entire research process that makes a valuable contribution to almost every operational steps in a research work. So, literature review, you know, is a study of published and unpublished work in the area of specific interest to the research work. So, this is the literature review. Now see, some steps are to be followed to do a literature review. What are these steps we have to follow to do a literature review? Yes, actually, we have to find the, you have to define the literature research topic. That is, we have to select our topic. We have to understand our topic. We have to find out our topic. And it is possible only by the study of the literature on that topic. So we have to select, we have to choose the research topic. And research topic is a subject, is a issue, research issue that a researcher is interested in when conducting a research. And the next step is compilation, a list of keywords, very important steps, because keywords means here the significant terms that describe our content, that describe our thesis, research problem, that address our research problem, that is the keywords of this research topic. So we have to make a list of keywords. And also it is important the selection of appropriate keywords, because by using these keywords we have to find out the literature, appropriate literature, other we will not be able to find out the appropriate literature. So we have to identify, we have to select the appropriate keywords. It is very important. And if the research topic does not match the literature we have, then we will be misguided. There will be a research gap. So we have to identify the appropriate keywords on our research topic. Then on the basis of the keywords, we have to identify the sources of information that are available on this area. And that is, we have to find what have been written on this topic, what literature are available on this topic. This is the another important step for the research work. And if you find anything is relevant to our topic, then we have to find out the, we have to write down the bibliographical details of that document, of that documents of that literature. And after that, we have to find out the full text literature, because we have to study, we have to evaluate, we have to analyze that literature. So if we don't have the full text literature, it is not possible to study, analyze that. So full text literature is very important for a research work. And another thing is, where will we get the full text literature? Where will we get help? Identify to identify the sources of information. We can use so many sources of information, but I think library is a best source, because library is a, you know, a storehouse of the so many lots of primary sources, secondary sources, and tertiary sources. So library is the best source for finding the sources of information, for collecting the full text literature for this purpose. So as a research scholar, we have to use the library. And if anything find that is not available in our library, we may use the interlibrary loan facility. And you know the Vishwati Library Network is providing the interlibrary loan facility to our users. So by this way, we can collect the all sources of information that are available on our topic, and then the study, evaluation, and the analysis of that study. How we will do? Just ask yourself about the study. What sort of this study, the text it is? What type of methodology has been used here? What are the hypotheses? What are the content? What are the area of, what is the area of agreement? What are the analysis? What are the theories? Just ask yourself, then you will find the answer. That is the study, that is the analysis of the literature. And ultimate aim, we have to find out a gap in the previous literature, otherwise we will not do the work. And next step, we have to divide the literature. Those are support our study, and those are not support our study. That is the literature which support or related our study and which are not related to our, these two categories we have to identify. And then we have to make, we have to identify the relationship between the our study and the works in the literature. So this is the another important step. And ultimately we have, we make a plan how we'll use this literature, how we'll apply, how we can apply this literature in our study. This is a different steps, important steps we have to follow to do a literature review. Now, next, how we can find out new things? Just see, here ABC are the three major works on a particular topic. And some related works have been done on base of this ABC, these major works. If we think to do something on this area, then we have to study all the major works and the related works that are already done on the basis of the major works. Then we may get, we may find out new things. We may able to find out the area of missing area of knowledge, and then we can think for my study. So in this way, a research scholar can find the research gap, new thing, by digging into the literature. Next step, the purpose of the literature review. You know, the literature review has an important role in a research work. It has, it helps to shaping our research problem. It defines the relationship between our research and previous research. It helps to develop our methodology. It helps to identification of the research area. So research literature review is very important in a research work because it helps to increase the depth and breadth of the research. It helps to support the significance of the research and also helps to identify the important issues and links to hypotheses. And this literature review helps to identify the key area of missing knowledge, describe the methodology, describe the existing data set, and also link proposed research to previous and ongoing research. And another important role of a literature review is that it ensures that this research has not been done before. If once this research has done, we cannot do it. It will be a duplicate work. So we have to confirm that this research, whether it is done or not. So only the literature review ensures that this research had not been done yet. So, and also literature review helps us to understand the structure of the problem. It helps to synthesize previous perspectives and develop our own perspectives. And literature review helps to show the way to future research. This is the important roles, this is the functions, important functions of a literature review. So we can easily think, we will understand that literature review is a very, very important part of a research work. Now, next step is writing the literature review. We have collected literature, we have analyzed the literature, we have studied the literature. Now the time of writing the literature. How we can write a literature review? In a particular literature review, there are four parts. Introduction part, body part, conclusion, and references. So in introduction part, we have to highlight the definition of the topic, importance of the topic, scope of the study. This type of information will come under the introduction part. And in body part, we have to focus on the theories, development of theories, area of agreement, controversial area, methodology, hypothesis, analysis, and also the research gap. This type of information we have to give in the body part. And in conclusion part, the key findings of the literature, of the study, and the present state of the study in this area, and also the further suggestion, also the we have to provide the suggestion for the future study. This type of information deals with the conclusion. And last one is very important, that is references. So reference is one of the most important part of a literature review. That is, each and every literature must have a full references, recent references, complete references, and with bibliographical information. So these four parts of the literature review we have to keep in mind for that writing, at the writing of literature review. This is the important thing. Now, writing part is over. Then we have to organize how we'll present our literature review in our thesis. How we can organize our literature review in our thesis. Sometimes we see we do not follow any technique, organizing technique. It is not a right way to present our literature review in the thesis. So topical order is one of the technique, arrangement technique. We can follow it. According to this technique, we can arrange the literature review by main topics, that is, those literature review are closely related, directly related with the research problem, that will come first, and the research literature review, those are indirectly related, that will come next. And this is one type of arrangement technique, we can follow it. Next one is chronological order. According to this order, we can arrange our literature review by the date of the publication, date of the literature. So we can easily understand that it is a easy process, easy thing, easy technique. That's why most of the research scholar use this technique, and so it is a very common technique. Another technique is problem cost solution order. So according to this order, we can arrange our literature review from problem to solution. That is, literature review moves from the problem. The literature review, those are related with the problem base, that will come first, and the literature review, those are solution base, that will come next. So this is another type of technique we can follow in presenting our literature review in the thesis. Then the general to specific order. So in this technique, the broad-based study will come first, and the literature review, which focus on a specific study, which is on our topic, that will come next. It is also called a funnel approach. And specific to general order, just it is the opposite of the general to specific order. In this case, literature review is focused on the specific studies, that will come first, and thus the broad-based studies will come next. So these are the different techniques I mentioned here. One of these techniques we have to follow to present our literature review in the thesis. We cannot present our literature review arbitrarily. That is not be a good presentation of literature in the thesis. So this is the important steps we have to follow to organize our literature review in the thesis. Now see, sometimes we made some common errors in the literature review. Reviewing is not logically organized, just I mentioned earlier. We have to organize the literature review in logical way. That is, we have to follow our organizing technique. So it is important we should not do this type of mistakes. And another mistake we do, that sometimes we do not focus on the most important passage that are related with our study. So we have to focus on the important assets that are available, that are related directly and indirectly in our study. So that is another important things. Generally, we make the mistakes in the literature review. And also, sometimes some researcher, we do this. We include a lot of literature review. Some of them are not related with our study. So we should not include this type of study. If we think this study should be included to increase our number of pages, to increase the volume of thesis, so that is a not good practice, that is a not good idea. We have to be mentioned, included the all the literature review that are directly and indirectly related with our topic. So we should be aware about this. And sometimes we use the few incomplete references, few references, and outdated references. No, always we have to use the complete, correct and recent references. And next, writing in author's own words. This is the copy paste. Generally, we made this type of mistakes in our literature review. Sometimes we think the copy of the abstract of a particular literature and paste it in our thesis, just literature review is over. At this time, after this discussion, do you think so? I think no. Literature review is a critical assessment of the literature, is a evaluation of the literature. So we have to do this, and we have to follow the technique which is appropriate to do a literature review, appropriate for the literature review. So, and literature review should be summarized and should be paraphrased from the literature, and it should be written in our own words. It should not written in author's words. And recent references are omitted. Yes. 4 years ago, when we started the research work, we found a relevant text, relevant data. I copied. I forget to copy the references of that literature. After the 4 years, when we come to complete that study, when we come to ready to the thesis, then we find there is no references for this text. But before 4 years, which references, which literature we have had used, I cannot remember it now. So at this situation, what type of decision we take? Generally, we take to omit the reference. It is a very easy process to solve the solution, I think, but it is not a solution of the problem. Rather, it brings all the problems. There may be arise the legal issues. So each and every literature must have complete, correct and recent references. So these are this is a checklist of literature review, you can think. So this type of mistake we should not be done for writing a literature review. Always we should keep in our mind these common errors. We should avoid these common errors in writing the literature review. Now see, there are two types of literature reviews given. One is a good literature review, another is poor literature review. And some attributes are mentioned here which makes a literature review is good, which makes a literature review is poor. So a good literature review is a synthesis of available research. It should not be an annotated bibliography. A good literature review is a critical assessment, critical evaluation of literature. It should not be confined to the description and summarization of the literature on a particular topic. A good literature review has appropriate breadth and depth. It should not be narrow and shallow. It should be clear and concise. It should not be confusing and long-winded. A good literature review generally follows rigorous and consistent methods, constructing in a arbitrary way. is not a good literature review. It is a characteristics of the poor literature review. So, as a research scholar, always we will try to write a good literature review. And for this purpose, we have to keep in mind these points. How we can write a good literature review? So, at the time of writing, we have to keep in mind this point that makes a literature review is good. Now, let me conclude this topic that a literature review. You know, the literature review is a most important area of a research work. We have to do if we want to a research work. And I want to conclude just. I want to conclude just mentioning 5 C's. 5 C's of writing a literature review. And we should keep in mind that these 5 C's for writing a good literature review. First, C stand for the citation. Second, C denotes the compare of various theories, methodology, approaches, definitions, analysis expressed in the literature. Third, C stand for the contrast of the various theories, methodologies, hypotheses, analysis expressed in the study. Fourth stand for critique of the study, and 5C connects to our ongoing study to the previous study. This is this 5C we have to keep in mind of writing a literature review. So that's all of literature review, and I will start the next part of my lecture, that is the in-text citation and end-text citation. So from the terminology we can easily understand the meaning of this two term. In-text citation, that is within the text, a reference, a marked of materials which are mentioned within a text of an article, that is the in-text citation. And end-text citation, the full identification of the materials which are mentioned in the text as a in-text citation, and it is provided at the end of the full text, full identification of the materials is provided at the end of the text, end of the assignment, that is the end-text citation. So it is also known as the reference. Now see, I will see you 3 cases. Case number 1. Here, one passage is taken from the original source. I just read out the passage. In order to communicate effectively with other people, one must have a reasonably accurate idea of what they do and do not know that is pertinent to the communication. Treating people as though they have knowledge that they do not have can result in miscommunication and perhaps embracement. This text is taken from an original source written by Nickerson and published in the journal Psychological Bulletin in 1999. This text is written by a scholar in his own words. What he has written? He written, effective communication depends on a generally accurate knowledge of what the audience knows. If a speaker assumes too much knowledge about the subject, the audience will either misunderstand or be confused. This is written by a scholar in his own words on the basis of the original text. Now question is whether it is plagiarism. Yes, answer is yes, it is a plagiarism. Why? Because he paraphrased from the original source, but he did not mention the citation and references of the original text. So that's why it is a plagiarism. Now case two. Here one scholar used a graph, figure, and taken from the WHO website. Now the question is same. Is this plagiarism? Answer is no, because the scholar has given the in-text citation that is mentioned in WHO within bracket WHO 2000, 2015. This is the in-text citation, and he also included the full bibliographical information in the reference list. That's why it is not a plagiarism, because we can use any text, any things from any sources, but we have to mention that sources. So that is in that cases plagiarism issue will not come. Now case three. There are two articles written by a single author. Their author is Krisen. He written article number one and published in the journal Language and Language Teaching in 2012. And another article Krisen written, that is article two, and published in Iranian Journal of Language Teaching Research, and published in 2013. Now the question is, he used some part of the text of article one in article two. Now the question is whether it is plagiarism. Answer is yes. Author of the both article the same, but he reused the text of article one in article two. He did not give in the original source. Here original source is article one. That's why it is a plagiarism. So from these three cases we can easily understand that what is the plagiarism. Now see some examples of plagiarism, when plagiarism issue arise. Now cutting and pasting from other sources, quoting without invited quote or a citation, without a citation, paraphrasing or summarizing without a citation, using images, tables, or graphs without a citation, reusing own work which was previously marked, translating a document from other language. These are the some examples of plagiarism. And also note that forgetting to cite is still plagiarism. So we have to aware about this to avoid the plagiarism. We have to cite each and every text. If we taken from other sources, we have to do this. Now see, why referencing? So to avoid the plagiarism, yes, to trace origin of ideas. Sometimes some scholar want to study the main sources of main literature, original literature. So by the referencing, we can trace the origin of ideas. To acknowledge other works. Suppose one author written a article and published in a journal. What is his expectation? He wants the money from others. No. He wants the citation. He wants the use of his article. This is his expectation. So we have to acknowledge other works. This is the expectation of the author. So we have to do this. And to get the authentication of the work, that is, referencing proves the authentication of the work. So for this reason, we have to cite the references. Now, see, in-text citation. There are three forms of using of in-text citation. We can use the in-text citation in three forms. One, we can use it at introductory phrase. We can start our writing by using the cite in-text citation. In second case, we can give the end of the statement. We can use the in-text citation at the end of the statement. And another form of writing the in-text citation, that is, we can use the number that corresponds the list of references, referencing entries. In three ways we can use the in-text citation. Now, there are some referencing systems I mentioned here, some common and widely used referencing styles are AP style, American Psychological Association referencing style, Emily style, Modern Language Association referencing style, Chicago referencing style, Harvard referencing style, and other some referencing we have that are not so common but still required at different places, like American Medical Association, AMA, ACS, American Chemical Society, American Mathematical Society, AMS, AGLC, American Guide to Legal Citation, CAC, CBE, that is Council of Science Editors, Council of Biology Editors, IEEE, Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers. These are the some references system I mentioned here, and some of them are very common, widely used, and some of them are not so common but still required, still uses by some at some places. So now see, which the student of which department use which type, generally use which type of referencing styles. The students of psychology, nursing, education and other social sciences generally use APS style. The student of literature, art and humanities generally use the MLS style. The student of history, information sciences and journalism generally use the Chicago referencing style. Business school student use the Harvard referencing style. Health science student, American Medical Association style. Chemistry students use American Chemical Society. Mathematical students use American Mathematical Society. And student of engineering discipline generally use the American Society of Civil Engineers. So we can understand that the student of which disciplines use the which type of referencing system generally. Now we'll see you some examples, and I use the APS style because it is a most important and famous style. Most of the users or research scholar use these styles. So we know that there are three parts in a author. We know full name, middle name and son name. All the referencing style, son name will come first, then the full name and middle name of the author. And sometimes it is seen that some style follow the full form of full name and middle name, and some styles use the only first letter of full name and middle name. APS style use the first letter of full name and middle name. So here I given some examples. I am showing you the books with one author. So the books written by one author, in this case we have to cite in this way in the reference list, that is King. Here King is the surname, then comma, space, then first letter of phone name, stop, space, within bracket we have to use the year of publication, then stop, space, then the title of the book. Then here are two parts of the title. One is main title, another is subtitle, and between this we have to use a colon to separate these two parts of the title, and it will be the wrestling with the angel is the main title of the book, then colon, space, then the subtitle, a life of Janet Frames, then stop, then space, then publisher, Auckland, place of publisher, sorry, comma, then space, then country name, New Zealand, then colon, then space, then Vikings the publisher. So the first letter of the first word of the main title, subtitle and other proper nouns have capital letters. This is the reference list. This is the reference and in-text citation. If we use the in-text citation as the end of the text, then we will write in this way, that is, with bracket, thing that is surname, comma, space, 2000, that is year of publication, then close of bracket, first bracket. So this is the end, this is the in-text citation is used at the end of the text. And if we use the in-text citation as an introductory phrase, then we have to start the in-text citation like this way, king, then space, then within bracket, year of publication, then space, then compares frame, like this we have right. So this is the in-text citation and reference. In case of book written by single author, in the APA style. In case of books with two authors, all are same. Just we have to use an ampersand sign between the two authors, and do not forget to put a comma before the ampersand sign. This is the reference. And in case of in-text citation of a book with two authors, then we have to use an ampersand sign between the two authors if we use the in-text citation at the end of the statement. That is, here Dancy space ampersand sign space ready comma space 2004. So, and if we use the in-text citation as an introductory phrase, then we have to use the and in place of ampersand sign, that is Dancy and ready, like this. So this is the difference form. This is the reference and in-text citation of books with two authors. Then in case of 3 to 5 authors, all are same. And in case of in-text citation, we have to use all authors, the first type, and in a subsequent citation includes only the first author, followed by etl, E-T-8, A-L, stop, comma. So this is the books with 3 to 5 authors. Now the 6 or more authors. In this case, all authors should be given when there are 6 or 7 authors. If a source have 8 to more authors, place 3 ellipsis points between the 6th and final author names to indicate that some names have been omitted. And in case of in-text citation, so the names, the first names and the appropriate, the name of the first authors and the appropriate of others to etl in the past and subsequent citation. So always we have to use the etl in case of in-text citation. Now books with corporate authors, that is book written and published by the organization or association or government department. Here International Labor Organization. So published and written by a book. In this case, when the author and the publisher are the same, use the author in publisher field. And in case of in-text citation, some group authors may be abbreviated in subsequent citation if they are readily recognizable. That is, here International Labor Organization is a famous organization, so we can use the abbreviated form of this organization as ILO in the subsequent citation if it is a recognizable organization. So books chapter in edited book, here something is different, we have to follow it. After the year of publication, then title of the chapter will come, then stop, then we have to use in before the writing of editors of the book. So then the title of the book and other information like other earlier, and include the page number of the chapter after the book title, and in case of in-text citation, the same. Now the ebook, all are equal, all are same, except we have to use the URL of the website if the DOI not available. What is DOI? DOI is a digital object identifier, is a unique code, is assigned for academic literatures, academic documents. So if there is available DOI is available, then we have to use that DOI in place of the URL of the website. Now the no author, in case of no author, the books with no author, so title will come first, as the, here you see of Merriam-Webster's Collegiate Dictionary is the title. So it comes first, then edition, if any. So in this we can write the book, we can cite the book with no author. And in case of in-text citation, we have to give the title in the text, capitalize all major words. So this is the in-text citation. And now the print journal, here author of the print journal first here, and then the article, title of the article, then after that we will use the title of the journal, and it is italic, then comma space, volume number, and within bracket, first bracket, issue number. And now see here, there is no space between the volume number and issue number, and volume number will be italic, like the title of the journal, then the page number. So in case of e-journal with DOI format, then all are same, like the print journal, we have to use the DOI unique code at the end of the after the page number, page mark. Then the journal without DOI, so in this case all are same, just we have to use the URL of the journal home page. Now the magazine, I will cite the magazine. So we have to mention the full date, and others is same. So if the magazine published weekly, then we have to mention the full date, and if it published monthly, so year, mention the month and year. And in case of newspaper, so it is same as the magazine. If it is available at online, then we have to use the online URL of the website. Now the thesis, dissertation, author, researcher, name of the researcher, date, and the title of the dissertation, that are maybe master's or doctoral dissertation or master dissertation, and we have to mention within first bracket doctoral dissertation or master dissertation. Then if we access the commercial, if we access from a commercial database, that is a ProQuest, like ProQuest, then we have to mention the name of database of ProQuest, and the which accession number or order number, whatever may be, is assigned. And if we access from a institutional repository, then we have to give in the URL of that website of the institutional repository. So this is the reference for thesis and dissertation. And then others, some other materials, sometimes we have to cite, like reference paper, conference papers, online authors, then we have to you have to mention the year, month of the conference, then the title of the article, then the paper presented at name of the conference and place of the conference, then retrieve from the URL. And in case of course handbook, handout, lecture notes, etc., then we have to mention the we have to mention the format within square bracket, that is a PowerPoint PowerPoint slide. He had mentioned it, the PowerPoint slide after the title of the course of the lecture note. Then the in case of prelim, that we have to mention the format, that is the motion picture within the square bracket after the title. So, and in case of web page, so we have to write the we have to mention the organization name of the organization, that is who is responsible for that particular web page, and then we have to mention the date or the update update latest update date, or if not available then ND, that is no date. So, and here agri business, that is the title of the web page, particular title of the web page from where we taken the information, agri business, and retrieve from that is the URL of that web page. So these are the things. Now see, if we think that managing the references by manual is difficult to a research scholar, we may use the reference management software also. Here, my best reference management software I mentioned, RepWorks, Zotero, EndNote, Mendeley, and CitesC. These are the five best management software available in our hand. And out of these five, you see two are paid software, that is RepWorks and EndNote is a paid software. We have to purchase it. And Zotero is a free and open source software, and other two, Mendeley and CitesC, is a free software. Also, these five software support the Microsoft Word and also the Open Office, except RepWorks, it only the support Microsoft Office. And these five softwares also able to capture the web page to create a record. Only the EndNote, except EndNote cannot capture the web page to create a record. So these are the five software, best five software I mentioned here, and these are the some core features that I told you. And you know that Zotero and Mendeley, these two software already discussed in our topic by the other resource person, so you know it, and I will not discuss much more about this. So this is the things that I, let me conclude it, this next part. So referencing system is very important for research work, like the literature review. So I just give a message, if we be honest, I will be safe in case of referencing system. If you have any question, you may ask me.
Sir, what about the research gap? Hello, sir. What is research gap?
What is research?
Research gap.
Yeah. Actually, research gap. why want to do our research, and why study the literature on a particular topic. If we think to do a research on a particular topic, then we have to study the topic on that particular literature on that particular topic, and we will find the missing knowledge of the previous study, previous that we have. So then we can make a, we can find out the gap that is the area that yet not touched by anyone. This is the research gap.
So I have a question.
Yes.
Yeah. When I take a reference from the net, I think we have to also mention the time and date, because that reference will change afterwards.
Sorry, it is not audible, please. There is some disturbance. I cannot understand. I cannot hear you.
When we take a reference from the net, in that case, apart from the URL, we should also mention the date and the time, because the reference may change later on.
Yes, you are right. Some techniques follow it, but APA, I mentioned here only the APA style, and APL style generally not recommended this type of date. You are right, because sometimes that if I use the source, that may be changed later on. So some cases we may use the date of the retrieval date also. APA style is not recommend, but we may use it. You're right.
Thank you. May I ask one more question, sir?
Yes.
One more question. Can I ask?
Yeah. You may ask. Please.
Future demon is, of course, yes. We also use it for our scholars. Somehow, I have a question sometimes. Suppose a very novel kind of work, innovative work. Does it get literature from? There may not be literature with it.
Hello?
Hello.
Please tell me. Ask me.
Work.
We use those studies.
Very innovative work, a new work for which literature available may not.
Literature is available.
This is a very new kind of work, new area, and maybe more research will be made in that area. What do you do in that case?
Sujit.
I'm not able to hear. Lots of this.
Yes.
There is a work which is very unique, a new kind of work. Or
so many disturbances, I cannot hear you clearly.
Dear participants, please mute your audio. Those who want to ask, please unmute, then you can ask. So all can hear clearly. I request that all the participants mute your audio, and those who want to ask a question, unmute, then you can ask the questions. If everybody was three at a time, nothing can be here, nothing should be clear. Participant may ask the questions. You can send your question in the chat box.
Only.
Those want to ask, please raise your hand. Then you can ask the questions. Because everybody is unmuted their audio and nothing is heard clearly.
Sir, can I cite my own works?
Yes, you can cite your own works, but you have to maintain the proper citation of the original work. Suppose you have two, I mentioned here, you have two or four or more than two articles, and you take some things from that articles, then you have to cite the original articles of you.
Okay, and sir, parallelly, I can mention it in literature review also.
Yeah. You can mention the literature review. There is no problem, because every literature review must have the its own citations.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Sir, after what time period would a work is considered as outdated?
No, actually, there is no period limitation, as I think, because if you see something is written so many years ago, and that is also revised by later, and you have used the latest references, but given the old, given the old references, that is problem. Article never be old, never expired.
Sir, how can I write the literature review if I take something from a website?
Yes, how will cite the references of the online literature. So that literature, there are specific performer as per different referencing style, then we can cite that reference according to this performer, according to this style. In API style, we have to mention the URL of the website from where you have collected. If there is no DOI, that is digital object identifier. If there is available DOI, then we have to mention the DOI. It is a permanent and unique code number, so we can easily identify that that particular literature by the searching DOI. So in this case, we can cite the references in this way.
That means I have to enter the total website in my literature review part.
Yes, you first author, then year of publication. But I am telling you as per API style. First author, then year of publication, then the title of the article, then title of the title of the journal, then published year, then volume number, issue number, page number. After that, after finishing of the general information of the particular journal, then you have to mention if you have taken the website, there is a URL is available, then you have to mention the retrieved from, then URL address. If not available, if there is available DOI, then you have to mention the only that DOI, not written, not no need to retain the retrieved from this one. Is it clear?
Sir, let me repeat the question which I was asking. You couldn't hear earlier.
Yes,
can
sir.
You hear me now, sir?
Yeah.
Actually, sir, in a case, of course, the way you have presented is wonderful. I'm really happy because we do the
Thank
same way only with our scholars. But
sir,
I have always a question. Suppose it's a very unique kind of research. Suppose
yes.
a very novel idea on which maybe this is a theory question. Maybe. There was no work done earlier.
Yeah.
In this case, what do we really do? Maybe no literature is available because no work was done earlier.
If we think so types of area, there is no so much available, so much literature. So there is no option we have. So you have. So in this case, your guide will be the best option to guide you. I think some literature will be there. Otherwise, how will get the idea? So I think your guide will guide you better in this way. How will cover the literature review?
Excuse
but
me, sir, I have a question.
We must do a chapter on literature review, isn't it? Chapter on literature review is a must. It's compulsory.
Chapter
probably.
On literature review is must because it is
yes.
an important component of the study. So you have to make one chapter, individual chapter for a literature review, and that is must.
In certain
Excuse
cases,
me, sir, I have
if you
a
do
question.
Research in the basic sciences where we can generate some new ideas which is not happened earlier. So in the basic science, this kind of research may be possible, but have some literature where you get the link to do such kind of work. So that should be mentioned in your literature review point.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
The next question, please.
Sir, I have a question. Yes. Sir, my name is Ritika Ghosh. I am a part-time researcher. In the Center for Comparative Literature, Vishwabharati University. So, first of all, I would like to express my gratitude for such a resourceful person. It is extremely helpful for us who are working, you know, long distance. Now, my question is very specific to citation. That is, what is the basic difference between MLA, APA style of citation? Because we usually get confused when we are trying to work citation. So the basic difference between MLA
there,
and APA when it
yes yes madam yes there are some difference, basic difference, there are some basic difference. So according to APA style, I mentioned here how we can cite our literature, and if you follow, you can follow anyone, you do not know all the site, you can follow the APA style or MLA style of Chicago style. Otherwise, you do not know all the style. Who are studying the research on this paper on the different style, and that is the work of that them. But as a research scholar, we should know only one style. That is that we will use our research work.
Thank you so much for your response.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, Chandra ji, you may ask your question.
Sir, can we use, say, if I am going through a paper and in that paper literature review has done, means some of the studies have done, and one of the study in that literature review is concerned with my topic. So can I use as it is in my means present study, that literature review part where that study is?
Yes, we can include it because we need to study that literature which are related to our works. So if something find that is related with your work, you can include this literature in your work.
Means that study can be included in my present work. Means whatever literature review that person has done. So I will give the proper.
No, there is no problem. If someone is presented in another person, so what is your problem? Your problem, your literature review have done, and that is related with your topic. So there is no problem. And one literature can be covered by so many researchers.
Okay, means I can use that also.
Yeah, you can use that.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you.
If you have any questions, you may ask. You can send your question in the chat box. Even you can send the email to Dr. Tapan.
Hello. Am I?
Hello?
Hello?
Ask your question, yes.
My question is, my discipline is Sanskrit related, so there are so many quotations. So I want that.
Can you repeat your question again? Can you repeat your question again? Any more questions? So
last of all, my thanks to my host, Sharma, and my colleague, and also Sujit Kujur, and let me quit. Thank you to all of you for listening me.
Thank you, Tapas, for your nice thanks and very informative deliberation. With thanks, and I think most of our researchers, faculties, and all the participants are benefited with your presentation. I assure you, all the participants, that we will distribute the PPTs and the after the last session. That's mean on we will distribute all the PPTs and the link for the PPTs. Thank you for joining us, and we wait for tomorrow's session. And we hope that in the same manner, tomorrow also the session will be organized. Thank you very much. I am going to the session.
Okay.
Oh,